Large Group Awareness Training. Large Group Awareness Training, LGAT, refers to activities usually offered by groups linked with the Human Potential Movement which claim to increase self-awareness and bring about desirable transformations in individuals' personal lives. They are noted for being unconventional and often take place over several days. LGAT programs may involve several hundred people at a time. Though early definitions cited LGATs as featuring unusually long durations, more recent texts describe the trainings as lasting from a few hours to a few days. Forsyth and Karazini cite Lieberman, 1994, as suggesting that at least 1.3 million Americans have taken part in LGAT sessions. Definitions of LGAT. Rubenstein compared large group awareness training to certain principles of cognitive therapy, such as the idea that people can change their lives by interpreting the way they view external circumstances. In the collection of essays Consumer Research, Postcards from the Edge, Discussing Behavioral and Economic Studies, the authors contrasted the enclosed locations used with large group awareness trainings with the relatively open environment of a variety store. The Handbook of Group Psychotherapy, 1994, described large group awareness training as focusing on philosophical, psychological and ethical issues. These relate to desires to increase people's personal effectiveness. Psychologist Dennis Kuhn's textbook, Psychology, A Journey, defined the term LGAT as referring to programs claiming to increase self-awareness and facilitate constructive personal change. Kuhn further defines large group awareness training in his book Introduction to Psychology. Kuhn and Mitterer emphasize the commercial nature of several LGATs. The evolution of LGAT providers. Luke Hilzer, writing in the Rocky Mountain News, identified leadership dynamics, in Operation 1967-1973, as the first of the genre psychologists call large group awareness training. Leadership dynamics directly or indirectly influenced several permutations of large group transformation trainings. Werner Erhard, successively associated with EST, WE&A and Landmark Education, trained as an instructor with Mind Dynamics. Michael Langon notes that Erhard Seminars training, EST, became in the popular mind the archetype for LGATs. While working for Holiday Magic, LifeSpring founder John Hanley attended a course at Leadership Dynamics. Chris Mattei, at the time a PhD candidate in clinical psychology, wrote that most of the current forms of large group awareness training as of 1999 were modeled after the Leadership Dynamics Institute. Mattei cited LifeSpring, Insight Seminars, PSI Seminars, New Warriors, and Impact as groups influenced by Leadership Dynamics. Academic analyses, studies. Large Group Awareness Training, a 1982 peer-reviewed article published in Annual Review of Psychology, sought to summarize literature on the subject of LGATs and to examine their efficacy and their relationship with more standard psychology. This academic article describes and analyzes large group awareness training from a psychological perspective. Influenced by the work of humanistic psychologists such as Carl Rogers, Abraham Maslow and Rollo May and sometimes associated with the Human Potential Movement. LGATs as commercial trainings took many techniques from encounter groups. They existed alongside but outside the domains of academic psychology or psychiatry. Their measure of performance was consumer satisfaction and formal research was seldom pursued. The article describes an EST training, and discusses the literature on the testimony of EST graduates. It notes minor changes on psychological tests after the training and mentions anecdotal reports of psychiatric casualties among EST trainees. The article considers how EST compares to more standard psychotherapy techniques such as behavior therapy, group and existential psychotherapy before concluding with a call for objective and rigorous research and stating that unknown variables might have accounted for some of the positive accounts. Psychologists advised borderline or psychotic patients not to participate. Psychological factors cited by academics include emotional flooding, catharsis, universality, identification with others, the instillation of hope, identification and what Sartre called uncontested authorship. In 1989, researchers from the University of Connecticut received the National Consultants to Management Award from the American Psychological Association for their study, Evaluating a Large Group Awareness Training. Psychologist Chris Matte has written in the interests of consumer protection, encouraging potential attendees of LCATs to discuss such trainings with any current therapist or counselor, to examine the principles underlying the program, and to determine pre-screening methods, the training of facilitators, the full cost of the training and of any suggested follow-up care. Finkelstein noted the many difficulties in evaluating LGATs, from proponents' explicit rejection of certain study models to difficulty in establishing a rigorous control group. In some cases, organizations on the study have partially funded research into themselves. Not all professional researchers view LGATs favorably. Researchers such as psychologist Philip Cushman, for example, found that the program he studied consists of a premeditated attack on the self. A 1983 study on LifeSpring found that although participants often experience a heightened sense of well-being as a consequence of the training, the phenomenon is essentially pathological, meaning that, in the program studied, the training systematically undermines ego functioning and promotes regression to the extent that reality testing is significantly impaired. Lieberman's 1987 study, funded partially by LifeSpring, noted that 5 out of a sample of 289 participants experienced stress reactions, including one transitory psychotic episode. He commented, "Whether would have experienced such stress under other conditions cannot be answered. The clinical evidence, however, is that the reactions were directly attributable to the large group awareness training." The Vatican has opined on New Age training courses. In Kuhn's psychology textbook, Introduction to Psychology, the author references many other studies, which postulate that many of the claimed benefits of large group awareness training actually take the form of a kind of therapy placebo effect. Jarvis described large group awareness training as educationally dubious in the 2002 book The Theory and Practice of Teaching. Tapper mentions that some large group awareness training and psychotherapy groups exemplify non-religious cults. Benjamin criticizes LGAT groups for their high prices and spiritual subtleties. LGAT techniques. Specific techniques used in some large group awareness trainings may include. LGATs utilize such techniques during long sessions, sometimes called marathon sessions. Parlia describes ESD's large group awareness training, marathon, 8-hour sessions, in which were confined and harassed, supposedly led to the breakdown of conventional ego, after which they were in effect born again. Finkelstein's 1982 article provides a detailed description of the structure and techniques of an Erhardt Seminars training event, techniques similar to those used in some group therapy and encounter groups. The academic textbook, Handbook of Group Psychotherapy, regards large group awareness training organizations as less open to leader differences, because they follow a detailed written plan that does not vary from one training to the next. In his book Life 102, LGAT participant and former trainer Peter McWilliams describes the basic technique of marathon trainings as pressure/release and asserts that advertising uses pressure/release all the time, as do good cop/bad cop police interrogations and revival meetings. By spending approximately half the time making a person feel bad and then suddenly reversing the feeling through effusive praise, the programs cause participants to experience a stress reaction and an endorphin high. McWilliams gives examples of various LGAT activities called processes with names such as Love Bomb, Lifeboat, Cocktail Party and Cradling, which take place over many hours and days, physically exhausting the participants to make them more susceptible to the trainer's message, whether in the participant's best interests or not. Although extremely critical of some LGATs, McWilliams found positive value in others, asserting that they varied not in technique but in the application of technique. LGATs and the anti-cult movement. After commissioning a report by Dr. Margaret Singer, the American Psychological Association subsequently rejected and strongly criticized a report by the APA Task Force on Deceptive and Indirect Methods of Persuasion and Control, in which the anti-cult psychologist Dr. Margaret Singer included large group awareness trainings as one example of what she called coercive persuasion. The APA characterized Singer's hypotheses as uninformed speculations based on skewed data and stated that the report in general lacked the scientific rigor and even-handed critical approach necessary for APA imprimatur. The APA also claimed that the specific methods by which Drs. Singer and Benson have arrived at their conclusions have also been rejected by all serious scholars in the field. Singer sued the APA, and lost on June 17, 1994. Despite the APA rejection of her report, Singer remained in good standing in the psychological research community. Singer reworked much of the report material into the book Cults in Our Midst, 1995, second edition, 2003, which she co-authored with Yonya Lalich. Singer and Lalich stated that large group awareness trainings tend to last at least 4 days and usually five. Their book mentions Erhard Seminar's training and its derivatives such as the Forum, Lifespring, Actualizations, MSIA/Insight and PSI seminars. In her book, Singer differentiated between the usage of the terms cult and large group awareness training, while pointing out some commonalities. Elsewhere she groups the two phenomena together in that they both use a shared set of thought reform techniques.